What's happening, ladies and gentlemen? This is Min from Architecture Inspirations. Today I'm going to show you how to use Proxy in Vray 3.6 for Sketchup. Let's get started. So what is Vray Proxy? Vray Proxy allows geometry to be imported from an external mesh at render time only. This means that the actual geometry is not present in the Sketchup scene and does not take up any resources. But when you render it, Vray will import the geometry from the exported mesh and it will render exactly the same way as the original model. This makes it possible to render large scenes with many, many triangles, more than Sketchup itself can handle. So let's start by creating a proxy. Here you can see a 3D model of the range that I use in my contemporary kitchen model. Because of the high detail in the object, the size of it alone is more than 80 megabytes. So it's a good idea to create a proxy of this model before importing it into my kitchen scene. Before I create a proxy of this object, I always make sure to save the Sketchup file in case anything goes wrong. Then to create the proxy, I first select the group or component that I want to make proxy. Next, I will press the Export Proxy button located on the Vray Objects toolbar. Then this window will pop up. Here you can choose the file path by clicking on this button. It's a good idea to export the proxy in the same folder or subfolder as the main Sketchup file. Next is the preview type. By default, it will be set as refined clustering, which will generate a more precise preview mesh, but it will be slightly slower than the other types. Next is vertex clustering. This method is faster than the previous one and generates a preview mesh that is not as accurate, but is fairly precise. The last one is phase skipping, which is the fastest preview method, but it does not give a precise mesh at all. For this model, I would set it as the default refined clustering preview type. The next option is faces in preview, which specifies how many faces are going to be shown in the preview mesh. Here is an example of a proxy with 10,000 faces versus one with 1,000 faces, and I'm just going to leave it at default value of 10,000 as well. Next is the Override Existing File option. When this is enabled, Vray will automatically override any existing VR mesh files. Last is the Replace Object with Proxy option. If you turn this off, then only the VR mesh will be created. But if this option is on, it will automatically replace the current object with a proxy. As you can see, the default settings for these options are usually good enough for me. Now, before I hit the export button, I'm going to open up the asset editor and go to the material tab. You can see here that this model has 4 different materials. Just pay attention to the materials list when I hit the export button. Right away, you can see 2 things happen. One is that the original model has been replaced with a proxy, and the other thing is that a new material has been added to our material list. This is called a multi-material, which is a material that combines all of the materials used in the original model of the proxy, which were these 4 materials here. And any part of the original model that didn't have a material will be set to none. Also, if you click on the proxy, it will switch to the geometry tab, where you can see the new proxy object on the list. On the right side, you will see more options such as where the VR mesh is located, and which preview type you want to use. Proxy preview is the default preview type, which is what we're seeing here. Next is whole mesh, which will display the original mesh, but can sometimes crash your scene. I don't recommend using this one. Then there is the bounding box type. This is very useful since it makes it very easy to position the object by selecting the midpoints and corners. Next is point origin, which previews the mesh as a bounding box outline with its own point of origin and axis indicator. Custom preview allows for changing the proxy file type without affecting or updating the preview geometry. I will set it as the default proxy preview for now. Finally, the animation option allows Vray to render animated proxies as shown in this video here. Now I'm going to test render it using the interactive render button. Looking pretty good. If you have Vray 3.6, then you can use this viewport render button as well. Pretty cool, huh? So that's how you export a proxy. But how do you import this proxy into another model? Before I show you that, I'm going to find the proxy multi-material and I will rename it like so. Then I'm going to right click and save it in my materials folder. Now I'm going to open up another SketchUp scene and import my proxy. There are three methods of importing a proxy to a new SketchUp scene. 1. Import proxy mesh. To import the proxy mesh, just go up here and click Import Proxy button. Then find and load the VR mesh that we exported earlier. Let's test render it to see how it looks. As you can see, the mesh didn't come with any materials, and that's why this one is my least favorite method to import a proxy. You can take a look at the material editor and see that all of these materials have been randomly created as solid colors. Also, this is what the old proxy material looked like, while the new one looks like this. So to fix this, click on this button and import the Vray material that we exported from the original proxy file. And there it is. The original Vray material has been imported. What we need to do now is to use this original proxy material as a replacement for our new proxy material. To do that, right-click the original proxy material and choose Use as Replacement. Then go up to the new proxy material, right-click, and choose Replace. In version 3.4, you need to use Copy and Paste instead. Now restart the interactive render, and there we go, it's fixed now. And since we have replaced these new materials with the original, we don't need these anymore, so we can just delete them. Another method you can use is to manually change the input of this new proxy material to match the materials of the original proxy in the correct order. Number 2, the copy and paste method. Right after you create a proxy from the original model, you can simply select the proxy and press Ctrl C to copy, then go over to your new SketchUp scene and press Ctrl P to paste. Now test render it. And there you go, simple, huh? Finally, my favorite method of importing a proxy is the import proxy SketchUp file. First, I will need to save the original proxy by right-clicking the component and save it as a new file like so. Now I can open up that folder with the proxy SketchUp model that I just saved, and I can import it by dragging in the file like so. Or I can go to File, Import, and select that file. Let's start the render to see how it looks. There you go. Either way works. Also, this method is really cool because it makes it so easy to update your proxy. For example, if I were to go in and make some changes to the original model like so, then export this model as a proxy, I can save it as the original one, but in this case, I would save it as a new mesh. Now I can right-click it, save it as a SketchUp file, then in my SketchUp scene, right-click the component and click Reload, then load the SketchUp file of the updated proxy. Now let's render it. There you go. And if I don't like the change, I can always load the old file like so. There you go. That's how easy it is to update a proxy with this method. If you only want to replace a material, you can do it in the material editor. You don't have to go to the original file to update it. Let's say I want to use this green plastic material for my model. I can drag it in here to add it to my material list. Then I would select the proxy material and click on the material that I want to replace, which is the aluminum material in this case. Then I can select the new plastic material I just added. Now let's re-render it. And there you go. Now if you want to update a material, you can do it as usual. Go to the material that you want to update, make the changes, then re-render it. Easy peasy. And there you go, guys. That's how to use proxy in Vray 3.6 for SketchUp. Now you can use this workflow to reduce the size of your model. Just use it on the objects that take a lot of space. For example, this model I use it on the mini fridge and the range. Or you can even use it for everything in the scene if you like. This was part of the merch package that I recently released on my Patreon. I also like to thank all of those who supported me by signing up. You guys are freaking awesome. This package has been sent out and won't be available on Patreon anymore, but it's on Gumroad now for those who want to get it. And that is all for today, guys. Leave a like if you enjoyed the video. Comment below if you have any suggestions. Stay inspired, guys, and I'll see you next time.